The title of my sermon is You Raise Me Up, and later on there'll be a song presentation based on this song as well. Yeah, so the scripture reading for today is taken from Luke chapter 5. So before I go into what is really Community Weekend, basically Community Weekend is truly a celebration of God's goodness and faithfulness to the two ministries, which is the Life Community Center and Blessed Ministry, and how God has used us to be a blessing to the community. So it is truly a celebration of God's goodness and faithfulness. So before I go into my sermon, which is based on Luke chapter 5, let me read this for you. One day Jesus was teaching, and Pharisees and teachers of the law were sitting there. They had come from every village of Galilee and from Judea and Jerusalem, and the power of the Lord was with Jesus to heal the sick. Some men came carrying a paralyzed man on a mat and tried to take him into the house to lay him before Jesus. When they could not find a way to do this because of the crowd, they went up on the roof and lowered him on his mat through the tiles into the middle of the crowd, right in front of Jesus. When Jesus saw their faith, he said, "Friend, your sins are forgiven." The Pharisee and the teachers of the law began thinking to themselves, "Who is this fellow who speaks blasphemy? Who can forgive sins but God alone?" Jesus knew what they were thinking and asked, "Why are you thinking these things in your hearts? Which is easier to say, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Get up and walk'? But I want you to know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins." So he said to the paralyzed man, "I tell you, get up, take up your mat, and go home." Yeah, I'll come back to this when I preach my sermon. So this morning, I'm going to share with you what we call the church-based community outreaches of SIBKL. Earlier this year, you would have heard Sister Melissa shared to you about Generosity Gemilang, and that is a full-fledged NGO that is also the brainchild of our church, actually. So that is the NGO side of things. For today, we're going to talk about Life Community Center and Blessed Ministry, and this is a church-based community arm. Okay, so for Life Community Center, this is the structure. Pastor Gilbert Wee is the pastor in charge. He is now on sabbatical leave in the United States, so he'll be back next month. Vincent Chia is the ministry leader, and Nancy Shim is the ministry staff. And of course, we have the volunteers and all these core members. So there's also a board which comprised of Pastor Gilbert, Pastor Chiu, Larry, who is one of our council members, and Chuli Lee, our general manager, and of course, Vincent. Okay, so if you are new to the church and you do not know where LCC is or Life Community Center, it is in Sunway Mass, and this is the address. So it is a corner shop lot, and we are so thankful for Tan Sri Chanachai, who let us use this premises FOC, free of charge. Okay, so there's no rental, and we truly are so grateful to Tan Sri Chan for letting us use this place. So truly, God has blessed us. So what's the goal of Life Community Center? So this is their anchoring verse in John 10:10. "The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I have come that they may have life and have it to the full." And that's why they name themselves Life Community Center. So their goal is to be a Christian community center, serving as a bridge between the church and the community for Christ by creating programs and activities to serve the social, educational, spiritual needs of the community. Okay, so you can see the keyword here, program, and some people say, "Aiyo, why SIBKL so many programs?" Okay, so we are not having programs for program's sake. Okay, the programs serve a purpose, And it is a means to an end, and there is to bless the community out there. Yeah. So it is not that we love programs, and everything actually is a program. Even today's service is a program. I have to plan the flow. I have to plan which item will come next and when my sermon comes in. So in church life, a lot of things are programmed. But it is not just for the sake of the program. It is to bless lives. Amen? So following the theme of the church, take the future, move forward. So LCC also has this theme for year 2022, moving forward, new beginning, new life. So why do they say new beginning, new life? If you remember, and I think you want to forget actually, we were 2 years under lockdown during the MCO. And that's why they have this new beginning, new life, because now that the borders are open and MCO is no longer MCO, so they are having this theme for year 2022. So what do they hope to achieve in 2022? They want to connect again with the community. They want to foster deeper relationships and to build life, of course. That is their aim. So these are the activities for the adults. So they have Alpha class, and some of the sisters that you see wearing green, they attended the Alpha class, and praise God, some of them became Christians. Yeah, so it is really something which LCC, they have done this, and they're continuing their Alpha class in Mandarin and Cantonese, I believe. Yeah, so sign up if you want to be part of their Alpha class. Then they also have cooking class. So if you want to learn how to cook, do sign up. They have happy hour, and this happy hour is not going to the pub and get drunk on drinks, yeah? So this happy hour is a cell group. So they meet in cell groups. Then they also have exercise, praise dance, sit-down exercise. So during the MCO, this sit-down exercise was very popular because even through Zoom, you can sit down and exercise. I wonder how many of you have done this sit-down exercise before. Oh, I see a couple of hands up there. Yeah, oh, all right. Okay, so they have dance class, ballroom dance, Latin dance, line dance, ukulele and harmonica. And they also have skill enrichment classes. They even teach people how to write a resume. They have art class, soft skill, life skills program. So there are quite a number of activities for the adults. So moving on to the children, they have English mentoring classes, kids station. This is the children's community church. They also have swimming classes, sports, enrichment class, skills enrichment, soft skills, life skills program, motivation class, and goal setting course. So if time permits, I may sign up for the swimming class as well as the ukulele. Yeah, so I urge you all to join me in this. Okay, so they also do house visitation. Yeah, so I believe this was during Chinese New Year time, where they go around to houses in Kampung Chempaka and they visit the community there. Yeah, so activities. Okay, so these are the line dance, the ukulele ladies, more dancing here. Yeah, and I think they're playing, looks like mahjong, I'm not sure. Yeah, and this is the line dance and also some other gatherings. Yeah. All right, so they also have outings. Yeah, so they went to Kajang for the Kajang satay. You know, they have picnics, you know, so they are quite a fun group. Yeah, so do sign up and join them, you know, if you want to be part of this fun group. Then they have children activities, art and craft, they have tuition, you know, they have singing classes and all that. So it is quite an activity-based community. And this is one of the most important thing that they do in Kampung Chempaka, which is to reach out to the community and also crisis relief. So during the recent floods, so I think this is a picture of one of the houses which were affected by the flooding in Kampung Chempaka. So they were helping the residents in Kampung Chempaka to clean up and also to give them their daily provisions, and also to bless them with some food. Yeah. So in appreciation of the community efforts that they do in Kampung Cempaka, recently, the ministry leader, Vincent Chia, received a recognition award from the head of the Kampung, chairman of MPKK, Kampung Cempaka, Teresa, and also the YB Jamalia, which is the Dun for Banda Utama. Come, let's give God a clap offering for this. So truly, God is no man's debtor, and they were recognized for their efforts. So you're seeing so many activities, and so few people serving. So this is how you can be part of this community. So we need you. So they need connectors, cooking, baking instructors, alpha class facilitators, drivers, English mentors, art teachers, basic music teachers for ukulele, guitar, and piano. Then for the kids station, which is the community children's church, they need game masters, technical team, musician, and teachers. So you are in for a treat, because the ladies from the Kampung Cempaka vicinity, the community, they are going to present to us a medley of songs on the ukulele as well to sing. Yeah, so these ladies are pre-believers, some of them. Some of them got saved through the Alpha class, and they are more than happy to bring you this medley of songs. So over to you, ukulele ladies.
Good morning! Good morning, all my brothers and sisters here. This is Christine Tin from Kampung Cempaka, and we are the LCC ukulele team! Today, we would like to bring to you a medley of God is So Good in Hokkien and English. Let's sing together with us!
Good to me.
few ukulele ladies. Wow, fantastic. So if you want to be part of this community, please do sign up and join them. And I'm sure you'll be greatly blessed, even as they have been a blessing to the community as well. Hallelujah. So right now, I'd like to share with you, moving on to what Bless Ministry is all about. So Bless, as you can see from the acronym BLESS, it stands for Bringing Life Through Evangelism and Social Services. Yeah. So this is the org chart. So I'm the pastor in charge, and we have a Bless board consisting of Yao Chan Soon, he's a council member, Tanya Lee and Sarah Woon. And under me, there's Catherine Pua, who's the head of Bless. And under Bless, there are four streams, which is the Bless Cafe. And Noah is the ministry staff. The ministry leader is Yat Sing. You will see his photograph afterwards. Bless Shop is run by Tina Chong. She's the senior operations manager. Then we have Bless Refugees. Noah is also a leader economics coach here. And of course, Bless Crossroads, which is the drug rehabilitation centers that we support. And Catherine is also helping in this area. So this is my portfolio as a pastor. So as you can see, marriage is under me. I also hold the license to be the registrar of marriage. So for those singles out there, if you are planning to get married, you can approach me, and I'm more than happy to marry you off. Yeah, not to marry you. Yeah, okay. All right, okay. So income generators for Bless Ministry, we are one of the ministries which generate our own income, but of course, this may not be enough, and we are so thankful to the church who come alongside us to support us as well, and the many sponsors and donors as well. So the income generators for Bless is Kedai Bless and also Bless Cafe. So some of you have eaten at the Bless Cafe, so do give us a feedback if you think that the nasi lemak is too spicy or not enough food. Please let us know. We'll try to improve as the weeks go by. So through the income that we generate from the Bless Shops and the Bless Cafe, it goes towards the Bless Initiative feeding program. We buy general provisions, educational books, school fees, and stationeries for the refugee schools. Then we also do leadership programs for the students and also support the teachers and the leaders there. We also support the urban poor, the marginalized communities, and last but not least, the drug rehabilitation centers. We also support them. So currently, there are five Bless Shops in these locations: Mid Valley, Chitamore, Ara Jaya, The Crimson, One Utama Shopping Center at the Old Wing, and Kedai Bless at SMCC. I forgot to wear the jacket which I bought at one of the Bless Shop, so I should have worn the jacket. The jacket looks exactly like this jacket that I'm wearing now, and it only cost me 20 ringgit. So you can really buy very good buys from Bless Shop. Yeah. So you'll be surprised, you may even see an LV or Prada in the shop. Yeah. So please do visit our Bless Shop. Yeah. So Bless Cafe, we are open. So every Sunday we sell food at the fourth floor, and it is open from 9 a.m. onwards. So please do bless us as well, because all the proceeds that we get from selling the food at the Bless Cafe go towards the Bless initiatives. So this weekend, you are in for a treat. So if you do not know where to go for lunch afterwards, please proceed one floor down. There's a galore of food to whet your appetite. So please, I don't know by the time you go down whether this is still on sale. I hope you still have some roast pork. Yeah, I think they're reserving for you to go down. So please make your way down afterwards, one floor down, and help yourself to a galore of food down there. Okay, so let me just give you a brief run-through of all the initiatives in Bless Ministry, starting with Bless Refugees. So we have what we call a feeding program. So 5 days in a week, we feed about 900 packs, and this is how much we spend in a week. In the month, 21,330 per month to feed 900 people 5 days in a week. So if you do your arithmetic and you divide this 21,000 over 900 packs, that works out to be 1 ringgit something per person per day. So you'd be wondering, what are we feeding them? But because of economies of skill, thank God, they managed to cook up quite a decent meal for the children. So if you want to come alongside us, you want to contribute and be a sponsor, let us know, and we're more than happy to have you on board to come alongside us. Yeah, so we also provide educational items and stationeries. So they're holding up their exercise books. So we also provide tablets and PCs for their learning as well. So we also support the running of the refugee schools. They need to pay rentals. They need to pay their electricity bill, water bills. So we help in supporting them so that their schools will continue to run. So as you can see, it is both physical and online as well. We also do Literonomics program. So you can see a volunteer teacher here teaching the students on some life principles. And also we do via Zoom. So this is Brother Noah teaching a Literonomics program via Zoom. So again, if you'd like to come alongside us, there's a booth outside after the service. You can sign up as a Literonomics coach. We also have empowerment and discipleship sessions, both physical and online. And this is my impartation, empowerment and discipleship session with the Myanmar head teachers. And this was a recent meeting at SMCC where I met up with the head teachers from the Myanmar school. So if you remember last year, we had our Daniel program. And thank you, SIBKL. You have been such a wonderful and generous church, because the proceeds from the Daniel program, part of it went to support what we call Bless Alive program. And so far, we have sponsored 13 students for their IGCSE exams, and we also gave love gifts to 42 refugee teachers to supplement their monthly income. So you may be wondering, even my children don't take IGCSE exams. Unfortunately for the refugees, because they are refugee status, they cannot enter into our government school. So this is the only examination that they can take. And that's why we feel that, you know, rather than give them fish all the time, we equip them, we educate them so that they are able to look for better jobs and a better career, and they will be a blessing to their own community. And that's why we feel that it is truly incumbent upon us to give them proper education. Yeah, so these are some of the students that we have blessed and helped them with the exam fees. So six girls and three boys. And this is their so-called appreciation note to all of us. Dear SIBKL members, we would like to thank you for sponsoring our exam fees. We have no words to describe our thankfulness and are beyond grateful for helping all of us to take the IGCSE examination. We have never once thought of being able to take the IGCSE examination, which is beyond our means. We will try our fullest effort to not disappoint you for your kindness. We hope you accept our most sincere thank you message. Thank you, SIBKL. You raise us up. Hello. Let's give God a clap offering. Really praise God for all of you for helping us, even in sponsoring their exam fees. So, we also have testimonies of students who are resettled. So these are two girls who are resettled in Adelaide, Australia, Elizabeth and Julie. So in order to be resettled in Australia, they have to pass their English exam. And praise God, Elizabeth and Julie, they aced their exam. They did very well. And this is truly thanks to the volunteer teachers who teach them English. They did not know a single word of English. But because you have trained them, you have coached them, they are able to pass their exams and now they are resettled in Australia. And these are two boys, John and Anthony. They are brothers and they have a powerful testimony. So if you read the testimony, our father passed away in Myanmar when we were very young and mother left us when she remarried and we lost contact with her. I'm thankful to God that my brother Anthony and I have resettled in Australia. We now have a chance to further our study and could have a brighter future in Australia. Praise God for the Leaderonomics class organized by Blessed Ministry. Leaderonomics lessons have changed our lives so much. So although they so-called do not have their parents anymore with them, but because of our coaching, because we taught them life skills, they are able to fend for themselves and now they are resettled in Adelaide, Australia. So thank God. And again, they say, thank you, SIBKL, you raise us up. Amen. So we also support Roof Education Center, and this is Pastor Michael Moy. He's the head of REC, and this is like a teachers training college for the refugee teachers. And many of the refugee teachers, they graduated from this Roof Education Center, and after that, they go back to their own community, their own schools, and they are able to teach the many subjects in their own schools. The other school that we support is Mikalai School of Destiny. So this is a school for the underprivileged and the underserved community. So many of these children come from displaced, underprivileged, broken families, abusive homes, and some of these, they have single parents. So the school is like a haven for them where they find hope. So this is Sister Mikalai Steve, who founded this school in 2016, and we support this school. Moving on to urban poor and marginalized communities. So these are some photographs of appreciative people that we have helped. So they say, thank you, SIBKL. You've been a blessing to them. And these are the categories of people that we help: single mothers, widower, widows, jobless, homeless, handicapped, and the crisis-stricken. So this is the picture of Ahwat and his brother. So we help Ahwat and the brother who live in the Lembah Subang area during the MCO with food aid. And later on, he requested whether we can hire him as an employee. And we hired Ahwat as a contract worker to help out at the Blessed warehouse. And he's also assisting the Blessed driver. So we not only give them food, and bless them with food vouchers, but we also try to create job opportunities for them as well. And last but not least is Blessed Crossroads. So these three gentlemen, Brother Bob, Pastor Richard, and Brother Elvie, they run the Kenosis Homes, which is a drug rehabilitation center. And truly, many drug addicts have gone through their rehabilitation program and they have been greatly blessed and come out of their drug addiction. Yeah, so this is the Rainbow Home for girls, Kenosis Home for guys, and this is the Mantin Home, and the Kenosis Home in Klang Valley, and the Rainbow Home for girls. So if you have signed up for our Isaiah series, you would have known that we are also thinking of setting a Kenosis Home for girls in Kuching, Sarawak. Although this doesn't come under the umbrella of Blessed Ministry, but it is our church initiative. And if you feel led to also sow into this initiative, do let us know and we will tell you further details on how you can be a blessing even in setting up this center in Kuching. Okay, so how can you help? you have heard about all these initiatives. So there's a booth outside afterwards where you can sign up to be a blessing. So we need literonomics coach, we need English teachers, math teachers, volunteer teachers, and other subjects. And no experience is required. You only need to speak in English. And even if your English is not the Queen's standard, it is okay. Yeah. So you only need to know English. Bless Cafe, we need cafe volunteer team. We need people to pick up the food because the food needs picking up. It doesn't arrive by its own. And we need food ideas and contributors. So one of the food items that people are craving for is for porridge. So if you know how to cook porridge, because the aunties who provided us for porridge couldn't cook for us anymore. So if you know how to cook porridge and you would like to volunteer, we'd like to hear from you, there's a booth outside. Please volunteer yourself. Thank you so much. And the other way that you can help and come alongside us to support is you can support us financially. So you can either scan this QR code or go to sibkl.org/my/giving and mark bless in the remark when you give. Right now, I'd like to play a video. And this video consists of testimonies of people who have truly been blessed, that truly, even through the blessed ministry, it has truly raised them up from where they were before to where they are now. So let's run the video.
My life before receiving help from SIBKL was very tough, because back in Myanmar, we didn't have enough food to eat and I didn't go to a proper school. So when I came here, when I arrived here, I didn't know any English at all. I started to pick up my English after I received help from SIBKL, because many volunteers, teachers are there in my school and they teach me patiently. I also learned to sing my first English worship song at Zomi Education Center.
I was 12 years old. I don't know how to read or write or speak English. Now I'm able to read and write and speak English.
I 就慢慢慢慢就跌下去，然后就碰毒品啊，继续这样子越来越糟糕的生活，然后不想再继续这样的方式来下去，然后就打算去 Rainbow Hope 的 Center 来戒毒这个问题。
Negara kita dilanda oleh COVID-19. Masa itu juga saya dipotong gaji oleh majikan saya dahulunya. Masa itu memang susah.
Dan sebelum saya mendapat pekerjaan ini, kehidupan saya begitu tidak sempurna. Dan saya di kampung hanya bercucuk tanam selama pandemik dua tahun. Hanya itu saja sumber pendapatan saya. Itu menjadi beban kami dalam soal ekonomi lah. Nah, dengan itu saya tanya dengan suami saya bolehkah mencari kerja di luar dari ini kampung? Dia cakap, kalau kau mau, sini ada satu kerja.
Saya begitu gembira sebab saya dapat bekerja di SIB Bless.
If there is no help, then I will just end up my life like my peers, maybe working at a restaurant or at a coffee shop, just being a waitress there, or else I might be getting married at a very young age.
Sekiranya besok tidak menerima saya bekerja di sini, mungkin ekonomi saya begitu susah.
如果没有接受到Rainbow Hope的帮助之下的话，会觉得生活会越来越差，然后后果就没有想象到会怎样。
Selama saya bekerja di sini dengan istri saya, pun apa yang saya rasa selama ini, SIBKL memang terbaik. Karena SIBKL adalah satu pekerjaan dan satu pelayanan bagi kami.
The supporters and to each and every one of contributors here, I would like to say thank you very much for helping me along the way. You might think that helping a refugee is in vain, but it is not. And here, I'm serving my people and my community. I'm passing back what I have received from you. Thank you, you raise me up.
Thank you, you raise me up.
Thank you, you raise me up.
You raise me up. So
Give it up for Bella. Bella is one of the refugee teachers in Association of Chin Refugee, ACR. And when she first came to Malaysia, she did not know a single word of English. Yeah, praise God. Praise God for Bella. You may be wondering, why am I singing so low? Because it's to match Bella, because I'm singing at a lady's note. Yeah, so for a guy to sing a lady's note, it's like... anyway, I hope you are blessed by the song. Okay, so let's move on to our sermon, Luke chapter 5. So 3 points. I know you're very kanchong to go down to the fourth floor. So give me another 5 minutes, 3 points. Learn from Jesus, leverage on each other, lift someone up. So even before Jesus did any miracles or pray for the sick or raise people from the dead, in Luke chapter 4, in a synagogue, he was reading from the book of Isaiah. And Luke 4:18, the Spirit of the Lord is on me because He has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind, to set the oppressed free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. So what can we learn from Jesus even through this passage? So we can learn from Jesus that even before we do anything, let us be filled with the Holy Spirit, to be like Jesus, to proclaim good news to the poor, set prisoners free, pray for healing of the sick, set the oppressed free, proclaim God's favor. So even here in LCC and Blessed Ministry, before we do anything, you know, we always follow 4 P's. And what are these 4 P's? Number one, we pray. After that, we plan. After that, we prepare. And after that, we pursue what we plan to do. Yeah, 4 P's. Pray, plan, prepare, pursue. And it is something that we always do, even for LCC and Bless. We don't just do programs for program's sake, but we always seek the Lord. And this is what we learn from Jesus, that even Jesus, amid his busyness in speaking to the people and healing the sick, he always go away to a secluded place, and he recharge himself by being in the Father's presence. And this is what we must do as well, even before we serve. Amen? So this is what we can learn from Jesus. And as you can see, even from the BLESS acronym, Bringing Life Through Evangelism and Social Services, evangelism play a major part in what we do. So even as you have read the passage, you'll be wondering, the 4 friends brought this paralyzed man to Jesus. And of course, their main intention is that their friend will be healed of the paralysis. But here it says, Jesus said, friend, your sins are forgiven. Now wait a minute. I came here for healing, and why you forgive my sins? Yeah, so more than being healed of his paralysis, I think for us, the paralysis of our soul needs to be resurrected. And this is the salvation that we need to pass on to people in the community. And that's why even in LCC, we have the Alpha class. And even in the Blessed Ministry, we also preach the gospel to them and we do evangelism. So this is part and parcel of what we do, not just social services. So be ministers of God's grace. So you may be asking me, Pastor, saya pun tak cukup makan. You know, I lost my job, I'm jobless. How can I be a blessing to others? Well, let us have the attitude of Apostle Paul. In 2 Corinthians 6 verse 10, it says, sorrowful yet always rejoicing, poor yet making many rich, having nothing and yet possessing everything. So although the Apostle Paul, he's not rich, but yet in this verse it says, poor yet making many rich. So how can you enrich another person by being a blessing to them? And it is not just dollars and cents, but even coming alongside them, praying for them, encouraging them, you are already being a blessing to them. So in Bless, we are very practical. So we do what we say that we do. So it's no point going to the refugee school, visit them, pray for them, and after that we say bye-bye, God bless you, I'll pray for you. But you go away from the place and you did not really plow into what they do. So the Bible always say, if you see somebody who's thirsty, give them a drink. If you see somebody who's hungry, we are to feed them. So faith without works is nothing, it's dead. So we have to really exercise our faith and also do good works. And this is where the social services part comes to play. Amen? So let us do what we say that we do and not just give a lip service only. So the next point is lavish on each other. So these four friends, and if you are as old as I am, these are the original Empat Sekawan. So back in those days, in black and white television, there is this series called Empat Sekawan. So I don't know how many of you remember the series, yeah? These are the four friends, and they broke through the roof and they lowered the paralyzed man right in front of Jesus. And when Jesus saw their faith, it is not the paralyzed man's faith, it is the four friends' faith. When Jesus saw their faith, Jesus said, "Friend, your sins are forgiven." And Charles Spurgeon has this to say, and it was these four friends who brought life to the paralyzed man through Jesus Christ. And this is what Charles Spurgeon said of these four friends. They need be strong, for the burden is heavy. They need be resolute, for the work will try their faith. They need be prayerful, for otherwise they labor in vain. They must be believing, or they will be utterly useless. So sometimes, even as we plow into the Blessed Ministry, and even in LCC, there are times that we may be a bit of frustrated, because we do not see immediate results, especially in the drug rehabilitation center. Sometimes, even after going through the drug rehabilitation, you know, you think that the person is drug-free, but after a while, they will make their way back to take drugs again. So this is something that we continually need to really labor and believe God will make a change even for them. So may our labor not ever be in vain. And as you can hear from the testimony of Din San, one of the teachers, that, you know, blessing and helping the foreigner is never a vain pursuit, yeah? It's never in vain. So let us be a blessing and let us leverage on one another. So if you can cook, you cook for us. If you can give, you give. If you can volunteer, you volunteer. So let us leverage on each other's strength. So Ecclesiastes, the verse is there. Two are better than one. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken. So people need the Lord and we need each other. For me, I cannot do this alone. So Pastor Jeffrey cannot do this alone. We need all of you. So as many of you to sign up to be a volunteer, to plow in to the ministry, and let us leverage on each other's strength. And the last point, let us lift someone up. So these four friends, they went up to the roof, they lift up their friends, and it was quite a heavy burden to carry a paralyzed man up to the roof, tear through the roof, and lower him down. So let us lift someone up this morning, that even as we make our lives a dedication to God, in Galatians 6 verse 2, let us carry each other's burden, and in this way, you will fulfill the law of Christ. And in Proverbs 21 verse 3, to do what is right and just is more acceptable to the Lord than sacrifice. And in the last verse of chapter 5 of Luke, everyone was amazed and gave praise to God. So this morning, even as you have heard this message and you have heard the testimonies of the many people who were blessed even by the ministry, I pray that you will come away from this place amazed and giving praise to God for what He has done even in the community. So if Jesus carried the weight of the world on His shoulders, He will carry you. So my dear brothers and sisters, no matter what you may be going through right now, you may not be in a position where you can give financially, that is okay. God knows your heart. But whatever that you may be going through right now, remember that God is there for you. He will raise you up and He will carry you again. Amen. So in summary, learn from Jesus. Have a heart of compassion like Jesus. Lavish on each other's strength. Lift someone up. And in Hebrews 6 verse 10, it says, God is not unjust. He will not forget your work and the love that you have shown Him as you have helped His people and continue to help them. Let us pray. Father God, we thank You, Lord, even for Community Weekend, that even as we have listened to the many testimonies of how You have raised so many of our brothers and sisters up, Lord, I pray, Lord, that this message will speak even to the congregation here physically and even online, that, O Lord, You will spur even our spirit to come alongside You, O Lord, to help the poor, the marginalized, the unserved community out there, Lord. And I pray, O Lord, that even for those who are underprivileged, that we will be there upholding them and raising them up from where they were before and place them even on a higher plane and a higher ground. So we thank You that even for each one of us, we thank You for Your love, and it was Your grace that have plucked us out from where we were before, that You have transported us from the dominion of darkness to the kingdom of Your marvelous light. And we pray, Lord, that we will do so even for the communities out there. And may You use our days, may You use our talents, may You use our giftings, may You use even our finance, our provisions, and whatever that we offer up to You, Lord. I pray, Lord, that You will multiply it, that You will truly expand it, Lord, that truly, even as You have blessed us, Lord, help us to be a blessing to others as well. And now, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the good Lord turn His countenance towards all of us and grant us His shalom peace. And all of God's people say, amen and amen. Hallelujah.